31 and 31 series continues. Today we're talking about the Los Angeles Kings. Dan Rosen here, EJ Hradek. The Kings, EJ, last year. -60 goal differential, worst in the league.
-60.
-60 goal differential. Wow. 199 goals for, 259 goals against. They had 71 points, their worst season since 2007-08. Change in the coach, Todd McClellan comes in. Rob Blake still the general manager, and I think there's an honesty between those two about where this team is right now, and the expectations are pretty low. Do you agree with that?
Well, I think that, maybe outwardly to the media, their expectations are low. I think in the room, all these guys always want to win.
Well, they all want to win.
And, but think about it, though. They still have Kopitar in the middle. They still have Doughty on defense. They still have Quick in goal. So when you have those kind of pieces, guys that have been successful, albeit now it's been 5 years, right, since that cup in 2014, there is a feeling that, hey, we can still get it done. And so last year just was a wash. They made a coaching change early. The team really never responded to Willie Desjardins, and so they start fresh. They've got to hope that some of the younger players they moved into their lineup now can start to have an impact and help prop up those older guys that are still good players.
Yeah.
I mean, Drew Doughty is still in the very prime of his career, but it was just too much to ask Drew Doughty to do so much on his own. And I think Drew Doughty probably bit off more than he could chew because he's such a competitive guy. So I think the younger players they're trying to push into their lineup, maybe that Gabriel Velarde, if he could finally crack the lineup this year, some of the players they picked up in trades, maybe those players can be helpful for them.
Jared Anderson Dolan's another one to look at there, a younger player. Carl Grundstrom,
absolutely,
another one.
Toronto.
Matt Roy, Sean Walker played last year on defense for them. But here's
so that's the thing. These guys are going to contribute. If the LA Kings are going to improve, these guys are going to have some. They're going to have a bite of this thing to help those stars that have been there a long time.
Well, and that's to your point on that. Andre Kopitar had 92 points in 82 games and was a Hart Trophy finalist two years ago. Last season he had 60 points in 81 games, and I mean there was just nothing there. Kovalchuk they brought in expecting him to maybe hopefully be a 25, 30 goal scorer. He had 16. He never responded to either coach.
I was not a fan of that. I think it's pretty clear the people who followed my comments over the years, I was not a big fan of that acquisition. But that just showed you where the LA Kings were. They were looking for patches to try to patch holes. They weren't scoring enough goals. They weren't getting enough out of the left side. Let's bring in Kovalchuk. We don't have to do anything but pay to get him. We don't have to trade any assets. And they were hoping that he could come in and provide more than he could really do at this point of his career. Remember, he had been out of the National Hockey League for several years. The game has gotten faster. Nobody gets faster as they get in their mid-30s. So I think that was a lot to ask right off the bat for him to be that helpful
for
them.
So you have to lower your expectations
For them? They're in a kind of rebuild on the fly because of the fact that they have Kopitar, they have Doughty, and they have Quick, right? And they have those guys signed to significant contracts. So they have to try to retool on the fly, or if they want to make it a bigger rebuild, try to move some of those pieces. But that's a bold move. And with those contracts, probably a very difficult one.
Well, I think Quick is the guy because the cap charge is not that big.
Yeah.
Quick is the guy that you can look to move. He has to have a big first half. Last year, Jonathan Quick struggles with health, and he was an .888 goalie.
Guy we've known before.
Cal Peterson was better. Jack Campbell, Cal Peterson.
Yeah, they both were better.
They were better. Jack Campbell, I mean, if you want to go on merit alone from last season, Jack Campbell should be the number one goaltender in the Los Angeles Kings. That's not going to be the case. But Jonathan Quick is a guy, if he has a good first half, maybe he can net you something in return. Because the way this is going right now with LA, they need more pieces. They need more in their system. If they're going to do a real rebuild, they need more in their system. Kopitar is excellent. He has to have a better year. Doughty is excellent. He needs to have a better year. But Quick can be a guy that can get you something, too.
Perhaps if the goalie market is always tricky, right?
It
depends
it
if there's teams
Find the team.
Need a goalie, right? You could. It just depends on how that plays out. What will they give up in return? Because you are, even though the cap charge for Quick isn't as significant as maybe it is for some other goal, he still has term.
Yeah.
And he's one of those guys that he's such an explosive player in terms of the way he plays physically. And that's shown with the injuries he's gotten now over the last several years. So that would be my concern if I was thinking about trying to acquire Jonathan Quick. But I'll be curious to see how things play out for Todd McClellan there. They do have, again, they have some high-end players there, but I don't know if there's enough around them right now. And I think this is gonna be a challenge, I think, for the LA Kings.
Do you think it's going to be a challenge to where they can overcome and at least challenge for a playoff spot?
I think it's going to be really difficult. I mean, I hate to bet against Doughty and Kopitar and even, you know, Dustin Brown. And, like, Jeff Carter has been kind of a non-factor since that injury a couple of years ago he got. He just doesn't seem to be the same player.
He had 33 points in 76 games.
Yeah.
And Tyler Toffoli's got to be a guy that steps up. He had 13 goals last year.
Yeah. He started to pick it up around the trade deadline when there was a lot of talk he was going to move.
Yeah.
He played very well. They had pockets where they played some pretty good hockey. But when I look at this roster right now, I think it's going to be a real challenge. And I think for the Kings, like a lot of teams that are in that position, what's really most important is have a good October. Put some wins together early. Give yourself a reason within that room to believe that you can get it done and hope to build on that as you go. But it's going to be a challenge.
I agree. It's a challenge. I do not see the Kings in the playoffs. Hopefully, they're not a minus 60 goal differential team again. Yeah. I don't think that'll happen again.